36 hours ke liye we have to work daily.
I have gone to the OT and I have asked for permission to sleep.
Government hospitals, there's a lot of patients, very few doctors.
कई बार डॉक्टर से सर कि वो खुद ही टीवी का बीमारी लेके जाते हैं यहाँ से.
अफसोस होता है हम लोग क्यों इस प्रोफेशन में आए हैं.
They hit me with a wooden rod that was broken off of the chair.
Every year, a cry to save our saviors resounds in our government hospitals. Violence against doctors have become so tragically common in India that in 2017, a survey by the Indian Medical Association reveals that at least 70% of our doctors face violence at their workplace. But are these isolated incidents? To find out, the Quint went on ground.
Junior doctors are usually the first point of contact for a patient in a hospital. Why is it then that they are met with threats, abuses and violence on a regular basis?
While declaring the death to them, one of them went and locked the wall from the inside so that no one could get in, while the rest of them began to assault me. Initially they hit me with their bare hands, following which they started to destroy hospital property. They broke chairs and tables. They hit me with a wooden rod that was broken off of the chair.
हम हमेशा इंडेंजर में वर्क करते हैं, डर के माहौल में काम करना हो,
लेकिन कर क्या सकते हैं, मजबूरी है, झेल रहे हैं.
सो व्हाट कॉजेस द डीप डिस्ट्रस्ट बिटवीन द जूनियर डॉक्टर्स एंड पेशेंट्स एंड व्हाट आर द कंडीशंस दैट दीज डॉक्टर्स कंटिन्यू टू वर्क इन इनह्यूमन वर्किंग आवर्स.
सुबह मॉर्निंग में 8 o'clock पे आया था, कल सुबह मतलब 24 आवर्स 8 o'clock पे मेरा ड्यूटी खत्म होगा. उसके बाद में 9 o'clock मॉर्निंग कल सुबह मतलब 1 घंटे की गैप के बाद में मुझे फिर दोबारा वार्ड जाना है. वो 9 o'clock से मेरा ड्यूटी एटलीस्ट 2 o'clock और 3 o'clock पे जाके खत्म हो जाएगा, मेरा काम खत्म हो जाता है. उसके बाद में मैं जाके लंच करूँगा, फिर मैं थोड़ा सा रेस्ट करूँगा, फिर 5 o'clock मुझे दोबारा वापस आना है फॉर इवनिंग राउंड्स. अभी तो जैसे इमरजेंसी आज तो आज हमारा डे रहता तो लगातार कभी कभी 36 आवर्स हो जाता है विदाउट एनी स्लीप.
आफ्टर 24 आवर शिफ्ट आई हैव गॉन टू द ओटी एंड आई हैव आस्क्ड फॉर परमिशन टू स्लीप एंड आई स्लेप्ट इन द ओटी अंडर द टेबल.
How many times do you think you take a loo break? Hmm.
Per day 2 times.
That's it?
हमको एक चाय पी मतलब एक कोई टी ब्रेक लेने के लिए भी 10 बार सोचना पड़ता है.
फिल्थ रैट्स एंड इन्फेक्शंस.
ये हमारे सोने के रूम में जो जीआर के सोने के जहां पे पीजी लोगों को सोने की व्यवस्था दी गई है पेशेंट के लिए भी है हमारे स्टाफ के लिए भी है. पेशेंट यूज करेंगे और इसमें नल का व्यवस्था नहीं, नल का व्यवस्था नहीं, पानी का सिस्टम नहीं. अब वो मेडिसिन वार्ड में चले जाइए, एक बड़ा सा वार्ड है जिसमें मल्टी ड्रग रेजिस्टेंट टीबी पेशेंट भी लेटा हुआ, एक एचआईवी पेशेंट भी लेटा हुआ, एक इम्यूनो कॉम्प्रोमाइज पेशेंट भी लेटा हुआ, एक कैंसर वाला पेशेंट भी लेटा हुआ. सब पेशेंट लेटे हुए एक साथ में, किसी का इन्फेक्शन किसी को लग रहा है वो ठीक होने आया था अपने इन्फेक्शन के लिए, साथ में दूसरा इन्फेक्शन लेके जा रहा है. अब उसी सिनेरियो में हम लोग भी काम कर रहे हैं. कई बार डॉक्टर से सर कि वो खुद ही टीबी का मतलब बीमारी लेके जाते हैं यहाँ से, मतलब वो बनने आए थे डॉक्टर बन के जा रहे हैं पेशेंट्स.
Lack of proper facilities.
Basic medicines are not available. This is the tertiary care hospital, medical college. We are running a PG courses here, and we are not at the medicines for the loose motion and vomiting. One serious patient came in the emergency with the chronic kidney disease with stage 5. This patient need the immediate the ventilator, but in our medical emergency there is no ventilators available. Basically, this is the right thing of the patient. Patient will get agitated.
What makes matters worse is often a lack of government infrastructure. Gets mistaken for negligence by junior doctors.
Patient who comes in, he wants an ICU bed, but here there are 30 odd ICU beds, and the patient actually needs an ICU bed, and there are no ICU beds for the patient. But he would have heard a speech from the CM or someone saying that go to government hospitals, every ICU, every kind of ventilator, everything is there. But then he comes here, and doctors are the first point of contact for them. So they might think that the doctors or who are the person who is working here are not doing enough to, you know, sort of even to give them a bed in the ICU.
All of these are not new problems. They have been there for decades.
I was in medical side, so we used to do 32 to 36 hours. The surgical side, 48, sometimes 72 hours non-stop.
And this is what decade are you? What decade are you talking about?
90s. Number of hours been. You know, it has been recognized much later. During our time, there were no rules in place.
The rules that Dr. Ray is referring to are from the central government's 1992 directives for working hours of junior doctors. One of the directives clearly states that nobody should be made to work more than 12 hours at a stretch. 27 years later, the rules are nowhere close to be followed. Almost all states in India have doctor protection laws in place. But when it comes to the implementation of these laws, here is the reality.
वो law है, but उसको कोई follow नहीं करता ना, वैसा कुछ होता नहीं है. उसको बुलाया भी नहीं, मेरे को एक दो बार और बुलाया था, but कुछ हुआ नहीं उस institutional FIR का.
There is no ready reckoner for the number of people booked under the Tamil Nadu Hospital Protection Act of 2008. Simply put, there is no visible accountability for people who indulge in violence against the doctors.
Treating the violence on doctors as a law and order problem is just one way to look at things. The real solution lies in huge policy change and the accountability of our invisible babus.
Patient frustrations and frustrations in relatives need to be better tackled by grief counseling, dedicated centers for the same on hospital premises. Unfortunately, none of these are available.
There should be a forum for postgraduate students to complain if they are being overworked. And if that complaint should be anonymous.
Somebody has to cover the hospital 24/7. So the only way to do it is to employ more people.
But maybe for starters, we should stop treating our doctors as gods and empathize with them as they fight to survive an already crumbling healthcare infrastructure.
It's a very helpless feeling to feel scared for your life while you're in your space of work. And as a resident doctor, it's also my place of home, it's my residence. So feeling scared in your own home is a terrifying feeling.